YouTube, and welcome back to another gaming video done by myself, Soupbullet. Today I decided I wanted to play Risk of Rain again, and today I figured I would play Commando, which is one of my least favorite characters. I'm not very good with Commando. I usually play Engineer, or Huntress, or Chef. So today I'm going to put on some artifacts. This one is use items are no longer, they are random, items are no longer random, which means when I open a chest, I'll be able to pick which items come out. But my way of compensating for those things is to have imps invade the map every 10 minutes, which means that a boss and a bunch of imp mobs spawn. And they have killed me in the past a great many times. So hopefully this is another entertaining playthrough of Risk of Rain. I really, really adore this game. Minus the few glitches that do actually happen. But for the most part, it's a very challenging yet rewarding game. If you are joining me for the first time and you've never seen Risk of Rain before, it's kind of it's a survival game, really, is what it is. The whole point is to complete each level and get yourself off of the alien planet that you've crash-landed onto. And each level you have to find a teleporter and survive till the end. Now, the trick is, you can't die. You've only got one life to make it through the game. So it's pretty tough sometimes when you're a little bit too weak and you've waited a little too long. The difficulty goes up, I believe, every 5 minutes, but every minute it seems to actually go up. It's just it actually increases a full level on your little bar up in the top right hand side of the screen. There is a bar, and that's your difficulty. Right now it says very easy, but it won't say that for very long. Hit that teleporter, get that timer started. Oh, nice. So I just used my random use item, and it was a time stop, which is awesome. Basically just turned these guys into a couple of victims. Now, hopefully I get some red items right off the bat. That will make this an awesome game. One of my last playthroughs was so fun because I got some really, really rare stuff right off the bat. And it made me so strong. But can't always get that. Go this one. I like to do a spread of the different items that I get right off the bat if I can when I'm choosing. Because kind of the beauty of this game is the variety of the items that you get. And if you just kind of sit and stack up on a certain few, you lose out on a lot of the random benefits that you get. So if you're like me and you like to choose your items, make sure you kind of randomly switch it up a little bit just to change up your game. Colossus dead! Yes! Much great success. Okay, now my first item that I always like to get out of the green chest is this one, Smart Shopper, because it makes them drop a lot more money so you can afford to open more chests and get more items before the end of the level. And War Banner's excellent off the bat because your experience to level is so low. You throw them down all the time. Like, I will put one down right now. Yes, just like that. Nice. Take that. So, my last Risk of Rain playthrough, I broke it up into a couple different episodes. I felt like it might have made it easier to watch, but I think this time I'm actually going to just leave it as one video. So hopefully it doesn't end up to be too long for those of you that don't like longer videos, but I think it should be okay. entertaining at least, hopefully. Bam. Oh, what? There's one more. Where are you? Dead. Okay. Get the heck out of here. I generally, on the first level, try not to spend more than 5 minutes on the level, or else the next one I find just ends up a little too tough. So I like to get out of here ASAP. And I think, what should I go with? This one. Oh, well, that's okay too. That's a pretty good item. Well, there's my first random item. Okay, where's the teleporter? See, that gong sound is letting me know that the difficulty just went up from very easy to easy. And easy's not so easy. Okay, so I got a war banner there, so I know if I need to come back to recover, I can do that. Okay. Die, Lemurians. Nice! Infusion, huge, right off the bat. Particularly because it's easy to kill stuff. And the sooner you get it, the more HP you get over time. Because what it does is every time you kill something, it gives you a little bit of an HP bonus. And it's, I believe, 1 HP per kill. So it doesn't seem like a lot, but it really, really adds up over time. Especially if you get more than one infusion item, you can really stack up. Die! Yes. I like the cave level. It's one of the nicer levels, if you ask me. This one. I hate the hive level. Hopefully we don't get that one. It's the worst. Ooh. This one. Anything healing is good. That's an imp. Oh! No, the imps did not invade the map yet. It hasn't been 10 minutes. Not that you were very much asking that, probably, but I'm just answering random questions. Yes! Oh, I'm so excited. Okay. So, I know what item I'm gonna get. I'm gonna get Wicked Ring. Critical hits decrease your timers, so it'll make me fast. This one. Yes. Nice. Oh my gosh, so fast. I'm so fast now. Oh, and tough. Look how much I can kill. Very exciting. Golden gun's good because you get a lot of money when you have the smart shopper. Okay, keep moving. Don't want to stick around in one place for too long. Okay, I'll go with meat chunks. Chunks! I turned into a meat eater. I was gonna say a cannibal, but you're not eating your own guys. You're eating the monsters. Where's the teleporter? Not up there. This one. Drop spike strips upon being hit. Okay, good, good, good. We like that. I'm so addicted to this game. Last night, I was up for way too many hours playing this game. Different character, but I was having such a good time. Ah! Ah, so close. I don't think I can get it. Oh, I need a jump item. Oh, there comes the imps. Oh, God. Oh, come on, come on, come on. Don't kill me. That's a load off. Let's go defense. Having a pretty good game so far. I'm really fortunate. Oh. Hopefully I don't get too cocky though. Keep yourself in check. Okay. Okay, good, good, good. Where's the teleporter? It's gotta be up here. There's only one other place it can be, actually, if it's not up there. But I don't think it's up there, so I'm not gonna bother looking. Two of them! Oh my gosh, this game just got awesome. Pretty much can do like my two toughest moves non-stop. That's amazing. Amazing! And this one. Oh, this one's good. Yes, yes, yes. Good, good, good. I feel so strong. What? Who just died? How did they die? I'll take it, but I didn't kill anybody over here. Okay, I think it's down below me. I went past it the first time. Dangerous business, this. Been here an awful long time. Uh-oh, Spaghetti-o. Oh, there we go. There's the teleporter. Exactly where I thought it would be. My eye is bugging me. Okay. Hit that HP shrine because they disappear once you hit them. Or hit the teleporter, I mean. Come on, one more. Yes. And the boss incoming. Do bristling fungus, because I don't think I have it. Nope. Okay. Nice, nice. Get away from that worm. Friggin' worm, get away from me! Ah, jerk. Oh, it's like turning into mayhem! Good. One of my favorite things to do in this game is just to become insanely tough. Get get a ridiculous amount of items and just wreck. It's just so much fun to me because it's so rewarding. It's such a tough game right off the bat. And when you can actually make it tough and just kill guys so fast without having to try, it's so rewarding. That's my favorite thing to do, is just keep going. Some people like the challenge, so they just blast through to the last level and do it as quickly as they can and win. I'm a bit of a milker. I like to make sure I'm ready for the fight I'm going in for. And so far, this is a great start. Like, I'm so lucky off this game. Oh, right off the bat. It's good. It's really good. Can't wait. And this is only the second level. Look how many items I have already. Need more healing, though. Bam! 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 There we go. Okay, gonna get that last. Oh, I can hit the teleporter? No, not quite. Says there's two mobs up above me. Not yet. Where are you? I'm coming to find. Nice. Okay. This is where running speed comes in handy. Quickly, get to the teleporter. Get out of there! That's my Arnold Schwarzenegger impression. It's apparently really good. You should be impressed. Oh dear. Okay, next level. Hopefully it goes just as well, but I'm already at hard. It's not good. Wow, that guy died really fast. Ooh, of course you don't give me anything, you jerk shrine. There's a secret here, and I'm gonna go look for it. And if it's here, I'm sorry for spoiler alerts. Spoiler alert! Boar level. Boar beach, as it were. This one is actually kind of cool because you can just farm the toxic beast mobs and get tons of items. And then you get this special guy here, drops this, which increases your strength. I have no idea what the other nonsense means. I'm hoping that it's increased strength. Forgive me, I seem to be stumbling over my own words today. Good stuff. I'm so tough. I like it a lot. Yeah. Now I just need some boars to spawn so I can kill them for items. I need more items. There it is. That guy. Oh, this is good. I don't don't really have to hit him. Yes. This. And his music was electric. Okay, kill that guy, kill that guy. Oh, poo! Sometimes it'll spawn a guy right before you go. But I don't want to spend too long on that level, just because it'll be to my detriment. And it sent me back here, so we're gonna start this level over again. I absolutely despise this level. It's one of just the worst. I don't like that the floor doesn't always go across on the top, like this level that I'm on here. Normally you can go all the way across and make it to the other side of the map and check across the top, but today they decided that they didn't want to do that for me. Come on, baby. Oh, this isn't good. These guys and their missiles. Come on, you can do it. Just keep them knocked back. Yes, excellent. Go with that, and we'll go with that. Since I don't have time to think about it, just kind of went with some good stuff that I know off default. Stun back. Come on, die. They're so tough. Okay. Get out of here. Get the teleporter. Oh my gosh. Tether. Oh my, oh my, oh my. Oh me, oh my. Let's do this one, just cause. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, I like being tough. It's so nice. Normally I struggle so much on this one, this level, but because I got those two red items, those rare ones, I'm actually doing really, really good. It's such a good game. This is perfect. I'm so glad. And I'm usually terrible with this character. Usually I'm just awful. So this is encouraging. Having an understanding of the builds is definitely really useful. When you're picking items, that is. Because certain jobs, characters, whatever you want to call them. I call them jobs because I played Final Fantasy XI for many, many years. And when you change classes, they're actually called jobs in that game. However, anyways, when you change your class in this game, there's different items that work the best, obviously, for each class, and ones that don't. For example, this one here, the syringe, is not very good for engineer because their primary attack is actually their missiles. I find it's the best attack for them. But the syringe doesn't affect that attack, so it's better to reduce your timers and things like that. So getting the rings like I got for this character is really beneficial, for example, on engineer. Okay, let's kill that guy since he's within shooting range. Yeah, yeah. Just wrecking this place. Aha! Now, hopefully the teleporter is somewhere close by and they're not going to make me go all the way over the map. But they probably will, because that's just how it goes. What I suspected. Up we go. Oh. I'm apparently very popular today. Well. Don't you know I'm making a YouTube video? I've been too involved in my risk of rain to be bothered by your peasantry. Okay. Oh man, I am so tough. I love it. I love it! Okay. Trying to just get a little bit of everything if I can. Since I already have so many items, this is crazy. I've never really seen so many so early. It's good though, because I could use them. Not complaining. Not complaining at all. Not even a little. Bam, bam, bam. I like the music in this game. Giant stone guard. He's blue. Why is he blue? What does he do? I'm scared. I don't want to find out. Stay away from me. Look how tough I am. He's dying so fast. This is awesome. Oh, but he dropped a white box? That's pretty pathetic. Let's get just some regular health regen. Since we didn't have any yet. So each level also has its own unique mobs, if you haven't really noticed that yet. Though some mobs will spawn on multiple levels, there's particular ones like these little snow guys. I don't know what these guys are here, these snow golems or something, but these guys only seem to spawn on this level as far as I know. And the very last level, I think, has everything. It's nice that each level has its own unique mobs. Gives every its own challenge every level. Okay, 16 mobs, 14 mobs. Die, die, die! I'm so dramatic, I know. Makes life a little more fun sometimes. Shouldn't let me get my war banner. Sucks to be you. Okay. And the guys that fell. Bam, bam, bam. Alright, I've got double jump! I forgot! That's awesome. Is there trouble with getting so many items right off the bat? You don't really know what you have so quickly. It's pretty unique, actually. This is pretty strange. It's a really good run for it. I apologize if my camera is focusing funny. It's kind of has problems with that. So, I'll just make picture. I try and move every now and again, so if it goes out of focus, it'll focus back in. I'm still getting used to this whole recording thing, so I apologize if there's random issues with my videos. Now, hopefully we don't get the one boss that I really dislike on this game, because this level has a lava guy that's pretty tough. So these things here in the wall are to be able to get the artifacts for this level. I'm not going to show that. I'm going to try and keep my spoilers to a minimum. So long as it doesn't, you know, affect my playthrough for any reason, I'm going to try and keep it. So if you have things that you haven't quite done yet, that you'll be able to at least enjoy those on your own. I'm apparently terrible for giving spoilers away. So I do apologize if you're one of those people who despises spoilers and I ruin something for you. It's most likely going to happen. It's just my nature. I don't really care about spoilers. I like to know what I'm getting into most of the time, so spoilers are something I actually enjoy. Not always, but sometimes. It's nice to go into a movie knowing someone's gonna die, or, you know, that kind of thing. I'm weird, I know. That's okay. I like me weird. Oh, wow. I'm running out of stuff to get that's random here. Gonna have to really start doubling up. Ooh. Did you hear that sick beat drop? It's like some dubstep going on in the music. I don't know if anybody else noticed that, but I definitely did. This one. Oh, I know what I do want to get. Especially if I get more drones. I'm going to get the arms race. It makes them so tough. Ah, teleporter. Get that. Oh, it is that boss I didn't want. Cremator! He's tough. He randomly throws, like, bombs at you. Like that. I better go kill him. He can shoot from across the screen. It's pretty rough. Get out of here. Getting a little bit hectic. Doing okay, but doesn't take much to get hit. Luckily, I just have a lot of healing items, which is amazing. Really, really not used to having so many. It's good, it's good, it's good. This is a perfect game to be recording, I think. Come on. Excellent. There he is. Hate you. There we go. Die! Oh, I have to go in the lava! I don't want to go in there! There we go. I did it! Let's go quickly explore. Since I know there's some stuff over here usually, maybe we can get some good stuff. Not that we don't have good stuff already! Yeah! I'm looking out my window right now, and it is snowing outside. I can't wait for spring. I'm tired of the snow. Okay, lots of items. This is excellent. I like this one. It's really good. It's like a little ice shield. Surrounds you with like these 3 or 4 ice spikes as you kill guys and damages them. It's pretty sweet. Random guys. Yes. Good. Okay. Almost done. Wow. I should have actually streamed. I should learn how to stream because I feel like this would be a great game to be interacting with people during and get suggestions while I'm playing if I should move on or continue doing something. I did mention this in the last playthrough. But if this is a game that you actually really enjoy watching, or don't enjoy watching, whatever, but you want to see more, I'd love to be able to hear from you guys, the audience, and get some suggestions on different playthrough styles, different characters to play, maybe some different artifacts to put on to make it more challenging or less challenging. Or, you know, just different things you'd like to see as a playthrough. I would be more than happy to give it a go. I can't guarantee I'll be good at anything, but I can give it a try. Do my best for you. I think the next level might be Hive. Oh, no, it's the temple. So, this is the final level before the final level. At this point, when I beat this and get the teleporter time all finished up and everything, I have the option to proceed to the next final level and beat the final boss, or I can proceed back through previous levels and it randomly puts me on to different ones. And which the benefit of doing that is to get more items and get stronger. The disadvantage of doing that, however, is it is quite tough going back. The difficulty per mob seems to just increase drastically. And it also increases the chances for boss spawns. Oops. Hopefully that didn't screw that up. I'm sorry. I apologize. So lots of times you'll fight a boss and two bosses spawn. It gets to be a little bit hectic, but it's really, really good to get all those extra items. So I usually go back and get stronger, which will be my plan most likely today. Because I'm a bit of a whore for items. Gotta collect them all. This one. Oh, I had one. Ha! Oh, well. Never hurts to double up on stuff. That's for sure. Scavenger. You get away from my stuff! You quit stealing my things! I'll steal you! steal it from you. What should I get? The clover. Oh my gosh. Bring it on. I ain't afraid of you. You and your scavenging. I'll teach you to take my stuff. As soon as I teach these guys not to take it. Bring it on, scavenger. Bring it. Oh, it's getting a little bit crazy. Crazy up in here. Oh, Lord. I kill you. I kill you dead. Nice, nice. Bitter root. What should I get? There we go. Something random. Head stompers, it is. I don't know if head stompers is really any use, but seems okay sometimes. I think stacked it might be okay. Moving on. So, as you can see, the teleporter is bigger and looks different than the other ones. And that means that it's capable of taking me to the last boss level. I don't think I'm gonna go. I think I'm gonna get tougher. I enjoy being insanely tough. It's more fun. It's way more fun. More strength stuff. Things to increase my damage. Some crowbars and some crit stuff. And what else should I get? What else can I get to make me tougher? Lots of mayhem going on the screen right now. Perfect. 30 seconds. Okay. Let's see. There we go. Spent too long in there trying to figure out what I wanted. And then go up there to the top. Oh, for Pete's sakes. Come on. Oh, there we go. Got so much money. Crowbar. Yes. Very good. Oh, and I missed 2 HP shrines. I don't know. I'm pretty tough. I've got quite a bit of stuff. Do I have one of those? Yes. Oh, I don't have one of these, though. I don't think I can get up there. I really don't think I can. Nope. Too bad. It's a guaranteed red item in the gold chests, if you can afford them. Well, I wouldn't say guaranteed, but it's an extremely high chance, it seems. I don't know that I've opened one and not gotten a red item. Okay, so we're going back to the first level. And we're gonna get some more stuff. I usually like to do a full cycle of levels, meaning that I go back all the way to what would normally be the last level, so the Temple of Elders or whatever it's called. And I usually, at that point is when I will move on to the last level. So unless something comes up and I feel like I need to smarten up and get out of here, I will be doing that. See. There's that shrine, so you can get the artifact in this level. Whenever you see these shrines over on the right side here. But as I said, I'm not gonna spoil anything. Not too much, anyway. It's there, you just have to figure out how to do it. Die, worm, die! I hate you, magma worm! Eck. Eck, eck, eck. Okay. So, most people really hate the wandering vagrant, which is this jellyfish thing that's following me around. But he's actually really, really easy to fight if you know his strategy, which I do. And next time I fight one, I'll explain it because I didn't really get to show it there. So next opportunity I have, I will explain what I'm doing and why. Now, where's this teleporter? Yes, I'm so tough. I'm so tough. This one. Wandering vagrant. Okay, here we go. So, the thing that you have to watch out for him is the little orbs that he shoots off. Those ones. They're like heat-seeking missiles, but he can't hurt you otherwise. So as soon as he starts throwing those out, I dodge out, and I turn around and just start shooting him, and he pretty much dies really fast, just like that. Crowbar. Need to get more damage per mob. Come on, baby. Do the sticky bomb. I think it's trying to tell me something. I think I should get the goat hoof. gosh, there's two of them. That's a little tougher. So far, I'm managing. Good, good. One down. One to go. But see what I said about more bosses popping on these levels? It's definitely a lot more challenging. But you get some good stuff. I mean, you get some really good stuff. So it's definitely worth it. Oh, heavens gracious. Take that, worm. Oh yeah, you're tough, aren't you, imp? Take that. Oh yes. Itchy nose. Maybe this one. Okay, I think it's all over here, hopefully. 29 mobs in that little bunch? Wow. Whew. Nice. It's going good. Going good, going good. Liking it. Yes! Great success. Moving on! Wow, this is a very long video. I apologize if you're getting tired of it. Hopefully I've been mostly entertaining and worth watching for so far 52 minutes. I did mention in my very first playthrough that I posted that I could easily be playing for over 60 minutes when you get a good game. And it seems like that's what I got, is a good game. So... Oy, oy, oy. It's good. I'm glad. I'm not complaining. I'm definitely not complaining. One of the better play flues I've had for sure. Let's give us another mortar. Time to double up. Gosh, look how fast I'm attacking. So fast. So much money. Oh, I didn't even mean to grab that. No, no, I wanted something else. I need to upgrade my drones next. You can get so that they have missiles and mortars that launch off of them, so they're really tough. Tougher than they even are already. Oh gosh. Okay. I hope I don't die. But I don't think I will, because I've been doing really good. just never know. Sometimes you think you're doing an excellent game and something happens. You get too overwhelmed just by a little and not enough healing items or something of the right kind. I think I've done pretty well spreading out the types of healing items I have, which makes it, I think, a little bit better in my case, just because I don't have one specific type of healing over anything else. The other thing, I don't know if I mentioned this, but that I like to do when I'm playing with picking items is if there is three like that and it has two that are pre-chosen, I like to go with the pre-chosen ones just because sometimes the game knows what you need. You don't think a certain item is very good and then the game sort of forces you to try it and you go with that and it works really well sometimes. That's what I've been finding, so I like to just use what they give me sometimes. Not always. I think I know better than I will, but I just make it a policy. Pick the random. That's so much experience from all the money. This is such an excellent playthrough. I'm so glad. But now you just watch. My next one's gonna be awful. It's usually how it goes. You get one or two good ones. And then the game just likes to screw with you. Let's kill this guy first. He's stun locked! Take that! Oh, you're so threatening, Colossus. I'm so afraid. Coming right for me. Oh no! Better watch out. Oh, he managed to stomp me a little bit. Wow, I'm doing good. For all the mayhem, nonsense, and whatnot. I need to get more dodging stuff. Those invasion scarves, that's what I want. I like the panic mines. Stacks up quite a bit. And if you get a lot of them, which I have in the past, you can lay down some pretty serious firepower when you get hit too hard. It's pretty fun. Okay, off we go. Kill some mobs. That was so close. Holy cow. I got so lucky that I didn't die. I guess the lesson of that is don't jump straight into the middle of a bunch of angry mobs. Didn't have much choice though. think... What the heck? Get some more dice. Moving on! Onwards and upwards! And I leveled up right before I moved. Gimme, gimme, gimme! Where is that teleporter gonna be? I love killing mobs. I get slightly giggly every time. Oh, imps and a boar! Good! Yay! Keeping it real. Just keeping it real. I think, though, I'm gonna go get that other drone from up above. It was better. Even though it's more expensive. Flying winds. Okay. Not those guys. I need to move on. I'm tough and all, but... So, the other thing that I should probably mention is that certain items actually have a stackable cap. I can't remember all of them off by heart, but... It's generally around 7 for certain ones, like the soldier syringe, which makes you attack faster, and the critical hit glasses, I believe both stack at 7, as well as the evasion scarf. So you don't really want to get more than that, because otherwise you're just wasting your item. I think at a certain point, though, it's just like you have so many items you just don't care anymore. And that could very well be the case here pretty quick for me. Oh dear. Oh good. I used my timer. Use item ended up being a timer. So many mobs over here. Oh, I haven't found the teleporter! Here I am, just going on like, yeah, I found the teleporter, it's all good. Just killing off some mobs. Not so much. Might want to find the teleporter to stop the mobs from spawning. As soon as I clear this out. Panic mines stacked up. Okay, good. Bum. Okay, up. Going up. I kill you for following me. This is to my secret destination. You must not be allowed to follow me. Where is it? Up here. I find you. And die, Crematoor! And Scavenger, you can die too. Dunskies. Done like dinner. Dinner. Hopefully my food turned out okay. Now that I think about it, I've got some stuff in the slow cooker I should probably check on when I'm done doing this. Okay. And I'm gonna kill you mobs. Where is my timer? 70 seconds. 90. Good job. Thanks for coming out, bro. I love the double jump. It's amazing. You thought you could hide from me? I don't think so. Of course, it's pills that I use with my use item, not missiles or something useful. Okay, off to the next. I think this might drop us out. Well, it's hard to say where it's gonna drop us. Temple of the Elders. Okay, this will be the last one and we'll go on to the last level here. I won't keep you for too much longer. Where is the teleporter? I should have went up the other way actually. Just keep moving. I just love just knocking these guys back. They can't even attack or anything. They're so stunned and knockbacked, and it's awesome. It's awesome being impossibly tough. I think the prison shackles only stack to 3, so I'm gonna stop collecting those if I can help it, because I will likely end up with one regardless of whether I try and collect it or not. Ah! Okay, I need some money, clearly. Well, it's not going to take me very long to get that money. Not very long at all. Just like that. There's the red item I was saying I would get. Let's go with the photon jetpack. Whee! I can fly! Look, Ma! No hands! I wonder how many the crowbar stacks to. I should look up some of these numbers for my next playthrough. So I can remember what I should stop collecting certain items at. Another red! Oh my gosh. Ceremonial dagger's the best. Mm-hmm. Boss? She's always up here. It don't want to place gender roles. Please. Sorry. I'm not gonna rant about that. Oh! Here we go. Good stuff. I can't believe I survived that, actually. There was a lot of mobs. A lot of mayhem. This one and that one. I'm so strong. Impossibly strong. Well, I do hope that this game, this particular playthrough, at the very least, has shown you why this game is so much fun and how rewarding it can be, because it can be so tough off the bat. This one didn't really show the difficulty as well as maybe the last playthrough that I recorded, but it certainly, I think, shows why it's so fun and why I enjoy coming back to it time and time again. I mean, I play this game so much. It is in my pocket with Skyrim all the time. Like, I just can't even explain why I like it so much, but it's good. It's just too bad that there's a few small glitches that haven't been addressed, and sometimes it makes for a really frustrating game, because it can screw up some of the levels. So, you know, but other than those few glitches and things, it's a really solid game. It's simple. It's easy to learn. It's frustratingly fun. and it's replay value is good. I don't know what else to say about this game to convince you to play it and love it as much as I do. But it's kind of one of my always go back to games. Or when I'm not feeling that good, I like to play this one too. Oh, a couple of chests I missed. Nice. Wonder if I have. Yeah, looks like I have that other item I was gonna get. Ah, one I didn't have. I'm just trying to get items I don't have because I have so many. I don't think it matters anymore. We're moving on to the last level after this, which will be a very exciting level. hopefully I don't die, because that's entirely possible. I never say never. Never ever say never. Okay, we're going to the final level. Am I ready? I think I'm ready. I'm pretty certain I'm ready. So this is a garbage can. And there's a key card. Yay! We'll need that later. And we'll start opening this door. And a little mini one. Watch out! Oh no! One of the things that you do lose when you play like I have been with not having any random items is there are certain items that only drop from certain bosses. For example, the magma worm drops, I believe it's Burning Eye, and the Wandering Vagrant drops something else. I forget what it's called, but each one is specific to their mob style. Like the Burning Eye, for example, it takes the flame of the magma worm and makes it part of your arsenal, I guess. Same with the one that the Wandering Vagrant drops. It's a use item that it shoots out those little orbs that he just shot at me. And it is like heat-seeking missiles. Super tough, though. So I like doing those ones without the random items, or with random items, I should say, so that you can randomly pick up those things. It's nice to play a vanilla playthrough every once in a while. Make you have to work a little harder for your items. When you don't get to pick them, it's definitely way more challenging. And having the random use item, sometimes it's really useful, sometimes it's completely useless. And you never know what you're gonna get, right? So you have to just kind of hope that when you're hitting it in the middle of a fight that it's actually gonna be beneficial and not open up some random chest for you or something. Which has been known to happen in my case. Okay, here we go. Off we go. To the next room. Always need more missiles. Ew. Okay, here we go. I'm at this thing and I'm gonna start the timer. So each one of these rooms has a 30-second timer to get in or out if you're stuck inside somehow. Oh yes, good timer. Not back. How many evasion scarves I have. Four. Okay. I gotta just get these garbage cans because there's a key card most likely over here. And the key cards open up these other rooms so we can get some stuff to help us with the boss. We want all the help we can get. Let's double up. make it tough. And is there one over here, maybe? No? Maybe? Possibly? I don't think I'm gonna get that lucky today. Okay, sometimes there's a key card in these garbage cans, but clearly there's not today. What can I do? Nothing. Okay. Moving on. Going up. All the way up. Up, up, up. Up, up, up. Up to the top. Okay. Go to this level. A little bit too much in the mayhem. Open door. Oh, 7 seconds. Come on, come on, come on. I get anxious. Because I just want to win. I don't want to die. I don't want to stay tough. I think I'm going to be okay this level, though. So, my understanding is I'm supposed to be on a spaceship. The remains of a spaceship. Crashed here. This is how we're supposed to get off this godforsaken planet. Gotta kill the boss, which is what made us crash in the first place. He came onto our ship and blew up some stuff. Jerk. Okay. There's a secret here, but I'm not gonna show it. If you know it, that's great. You don't. It's worth it finding. Oh, there's another key card. Yay! Is there something over here? Yes, there is. Never turn down an item. Boxing gloves. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We have to go down below because there is a gold chest down there. I did see it, I think. So you might be asking yourself, how do I get that chest? Well, I'm about to show you a secret. It's not so much a secret, but it is how you get the chest. I think this one will be really useful for the boss. There we go. Now, I guess I'll go down and in. And, take ourselves to the final top level. Check out what's up there. Get ourselves to the box. Just keep moving. Just keep moving. Dodging just in case. You just never know. It's good tactics. Oh, Look at the laser across my screen! That was so tough! That was that red item I just picked up. Oh, another key card! Yay! Oh, yay! There's four you can collect. I think I have three. Yep, I have three. We don't get the fourth. I have the ability to cheat, sort of. I'll show you. It's not so much a secret, it's just more something that a lot of people just don't notice. So, we'll show it to you. If I need to. Panic mines. Mortar. And chest. We go. Tall enough to get up there, I don't think. There's the last key card. Much great success. Wow, it's like lagging my game out. There's so much going on. Whoa. Okay. Moving on. If you stay and try and fight mobs, you'll just end up going mental. Die, vagrant! Grab all this. Okay, I think I'm capped out on syringes for sure. I actually feel like the sunglasses I've been getting cap at 14. But I could be wrong. So I'm just gonna keep getting them. Don't really care. Doesn't really matter at this point. Don't think it matters. Everything's dying anyway. Regardless of what kind of stuff I have anymore. Grab this guy and we'll go down here. Okay. Yes, ukulele. I just didn't want the smart chopper because, well, it's just not necessary. Not anymore. But lots of drones. Okay. elevator into the medical bay. Now, some people don't notice, but you can open some stuff on the walls in here. It gives you tons of experience. Right here, these little red things. My goodness. Yeah, first aid from the medical bay. Oh my gosh. Nothing but mayhem. And a red item. Oh my gosh, I don't know what to get. What should I get? I think I will get this one. Just cause. Supplies. See, the big green thing is a whole bunch of experience that I just found in the wall. Okay, I'm gonna go last upstairs. The last two rooms, I'm gonna start the timer on my way up. So it counts down while I'm mucking around up there. Drones do their thing. This is just amazing. Running out of things to pick. Dice. Oh. I don't need no snake eyes. Oh, good. Bring it on! Yeah. Thanks for coming out. That was eventful. Oh, you decided to come invade my map, did you? Well, welcome to it. Why does it say there's still money here? Oh, that's a little weird that it didn't open the first time. That's okay, I'll take free items. Well, not free, I guess, really. Little guy, because I don't have him yet. And head stompers, just because. Die! Die! Mr. Frozen guy. Burning boots, yes! Okay, and now we will go fight the boss. Get into the last room before the boss. There it is. Last door. Are you ready? Are you ready for this? I don't think you are. What I'm gonna do is... let my drones do the work! Oh, fine. I'll do some work too. Since you're making me... yes. Almost done the timer. 29. 30. Open, says me! Yes. Yes, yes, yes! Ready? Here we go! Jump away. Baby. Oh, he's got quite a bit of health. He's not going down super fast. Maybe not quite as tough as I thought yet. I don't think I'm gonna die though. Oh! Get out of there! Oh, the timer. Yes! Beautiful. Oh my god, you're going down so fast now in Providence. Providence. That worm. Take it. Nah, I don't think I will. You die. Killed him a bunch with my sniper gun. I'm gonna go heal my drones. Just because I can. Bam! Holy moly, he's taking it. Taking it like a man! Yay. Almost dead though. This is so crazy. He's actually dying so fast. This is insane. Gonna die. Much great success. Ah, oh, beautiful. That was an amazing game. I really hope you enjoyed it. I certainly did. I just always love doing a playthrough. And so he left with everything but his humanity. And here we go. We're escaping the planet. Oh, wow. I can't believe I did it. Hopefully you really enjoyed that video. If you liked the video, please hit like. If you disliked the video, I guess hit dislike, but I really hope you didn't dislike it. If you'd like to see more, I do plan on putting out lots of new videos, so please subscribe and check back often. And let me know in the comments below if you would like me to play another playthrough, different type of playthrough, different characters, different whatever. I'd be happy to do that. And I hope you're having a fabulous day, YouTube. We'll catch you next time.